My dear children, my dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus. One of the shocking statements from the mouth of Jesus. Do you think that I have come to give peace on earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. People say, I go to the church that I may have peace. Jesus says, I did not come to bring peace on earth, but division. So unsettling. When Jesus was born, the angels sang, which we sing in every holy mass in the form of Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to people of goodwill. Jesus preached. We hear in the Sermon on the Mount, blessed are the peacemakers, they shall be called the children of God. The same Jesus is telling us today, I did not come to bring peace, but division. Other gospel says, I came to bring sword. What is peace? What is true peace? Is it merely absence of quarrel? Absence of quarrel doesn't mean there is true peace. It is presence of justice, my dear brothers and sisters. Why did Jesus say this? Because everyone who listens to Jesus is asked to give a response. Jesus goes on to say, in one family there are 5 persons. 3 give a positive response. 2 others, negative. Jesus says, even among the spouses, the husband may say yes, the wife may say no to God. The father may say yes, the son may say no. The mother may say yes, the daughter may say no, the mother-in-law may say yes, the daughter-in-law may say no, or maybe vice versa. It is possible, oh, in our family there is no quarrel, so we are a God-fearing family. Do not say like that. I am in the seminary, being a formator. Sometimes even seminarians may not like when you give correction. Should I keep quiet? Why should I unnecessarily tell them? They will never learn. They will never become worthy ministers of the gospel. You are silent when something wrong is going on in the family. Your child is all the time watching the TV only, or all the cartoon sites all the time, never opens the book, never. If I tell her, she will be angry, she will shout, she will even break the TV. Why should I tell? Can your mother keep quiet? Because we want peace. So let her do what she wants. Let me do what I want. Can we remain like that? The husband maybe has some friends who lead him astray. Are you not obliged to warn him? No. What you are doing is not proper. Some of you might have told the children or the other spouse, come on, get up early. Today is Sunday, 7 o'clock is the mass in our church. Let's get ready. Some others will say, no, we will sleep as long as possible. And then maybe if there is time, go for evening mass. Should you keep quiet every time like that? Every time like that. Jesus says there will be division. My dear brothers and sisters, the passage is reminding us of the early church. Some accepted Christ in the same family. Some others of the family did not accept Christ. Some of us are keeping quiet. Bury our conscience by false peace for fear of offending our dear ones. for fear of offending our dear ones. I have seen some mothers taking the side of children when the father is very conscientious about the gospel principles and corrects them. Leave him alone, some others say. I would say the father is right in this case. He wants the son to be a man of justice, to be attached to the principles. That's what Jesus says. I came to bring division. Not division permanently. Maybe the three who are against the two, in course of time will become four, will become five. That is the reason, my dear brothers and sisters, I came to bring division. Means I want some of you to be for me. And slowly and steadily, by your compassion, witness, understanding, you will make those who are divided also against me come to me. That's what Jesus expects, my dear brothers and sisters. And Jesus says, I came to cast fire upon the earth. What is this fire? Fire of love. Fire of the Holy Spirit. Jesus says, I ought to receive a baptism. What is this baptism? As he told James and John, the baptism is the baptism of suffering for the sake of love, for the sake of the gospel. We can't remain neutral when God's values are diminished, forsaken. The way Dante said, you know, to whom is reserved the hardest place in hell? Those who keep quiet when they have to speak. For them is reserved the hardest place in the hell. Oh, I don't take this side, I don't take this side. You know, the children are fighting. One is right, one may be wrong. One child wants to try everything, all the cakes. No, I don't give you even a single piece. If the father and mother keep quiet, something basically wrong with them. Jesus is asking them, come on, intervene with charity, with firmness. Intervene with charity and firmness. Most of the harm in the families are done because some people do very little to correct the erring members. Too little, too late. That's why irreparable damages are caused in the families. Jesus says, be ready to suffer. Be ready to suffer for justice, for truth, for fidelity to God. That is our whole vocation. Don't say, in our family we don't fight. That means, do you think your family belongs to God? Not necessarily. Is your family attached to God? Is there justice in your family? Is there charity in your family? Only then Jesus rejoices. Sometimes we come to the church and then pray, Lord, give us peace. There is no peace in the family. Sometimes Jesus says, better that there is no peace in the family because you are trying to stand for Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, today's first reading is taken from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah is one of the prophets who is in a way a figure of Jesus, very closely resembles Jesus. He was also not married like Jesus. And then his suffering, when we see, is really terrible. He is saying to the people, be converted, but people are not converted. Because he is speaking against the lifestyle of the people, they say, you are demoralizing our armies. You are plotting against us, so you should be punished. Let this Jeremiah be put to death, for he is weakening the hands of the soldiers by speaking such words to them, for this man is not seeking the welfare of this people, but their harm. Jesus also was told that he is subverting the people. That was one of the accusations, just as Jeremiah was accused in today's passage.
So what was the punishment? King Zedekiah. In the case of Jesus, there was one Pilate. Here Zedekiah. What he says? Behold, he is in your hands. King can do nothing against you. Do with him what you want. That's what Pilate also said with regard to Jesus. Then what happened? Jeremiah is cast into the cistern of Malchiah. And he is dropped in the cistern with the ropes. You know, the centurion said, truly this man is innocent. Like that, here is an Ethiopian, Ebedmel. He says, my lord the king, these men have done evil to Jeremiah. Only a stranger comes to the defense of Jeremiah also. And then finally he is saved. Jeremiah was not killed. But then 40 years of prophetic ministry, tortured, humiliated, beaten. What for? Because of his faithfulness to God. Because of his faithfulness to God. All the children want you to play. It doesn't mean you have not yet finished the homework. You also should join them. Even if you are the minority, you should stand for principles. You have to grow in life. Some of the people are there, maybe here also. They start watching the serials at 6:30, end at 11 o'clock. Is it worth? Did God create you for this? Not at all. Some others say, come on, we need also to have some family prayer. We need to talk to each other. We can know something constructive. Should we join the family? Oh, every family, all the serial, all the channel, going on watching 3.5 hours, 4 hours serial. My God, it is mind-boggling how God-given life is put to waste in some of the families. Fidelity to God, that's what is more important. Yes, you can watch one, two, understandable. You need healthy relaxation. But then not like that. Going on wasting time. I don't go into the details of each aspect of family life. You know what is right. God-given conscience speaks to you. The word of God speaks to you. God speaks to you through elders. Come on, what is life so full of care if we don't have time to stand and stare? Examine your lives. Not merely absence of fight or quarrel, but presence of God in our lives, my dear brothers and sisters. Presence of God in our lives, that's important. And we come to today's second reading, the letter to the Hebrews. It was written to encourage people, especially the Jewish Christians who wanted to go back to Jewish religion because they had to suffer. The writer tells them, come on, look at Jesus Christ. What a beautiful passage. In the 11th chapter, he spoke of so many people who remained faithful to God. Abraham, Moses, so many other prophets. They all remained faithful. Look at them. And finally, the writer says, we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses. Let us also lay aside every weight, lay aside a sin which clings so closely, and let us run with perseverance the race that is before us, looking to Jesus, the pioneer and protector of our faith. Look at Jesus, the pioneer and protector of our faith, who, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, despising the shame. Jesus accepted the cross. Jesus did not want to compromise. They wanted to stone to death the woman caught in adultery. Jesus said, come on, stone her to death. Jesus did not say. They found fault with the disciples for breaking the law of Sabbath. Jesus did not want to compromise. They wanted Jesus to keep quiet when the poor were persecuted. Jesus did not want to keep quiet.
Jesus comes to the defense of the defenseless. Jesus asserts the Father's will. They wanted Jesus to keep quiet when the temple was devastated, profaned by all kinds of activities. Jesus did not want to keep quiet. Jesus was prepared to suffer. John the Baptist was prepared to suffer. Why? My Father will not let me down. Ultimately, we do not know how long is this life. Sometimes we do not get the reward in this life itself. But my Father will not let me down. Here they said, Jesus looked at the joy that was set before him and said, my Father will give me joy. Jesus was sure about it. And then he endured the cross, despising the shame, and he is seated in the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him. Look at Jesus. Look at the saints. Look at the prophets who endured from sinners such hostility against himself, so that you may not grow weary or faint-hearted. Do not become tired. Do not become faint-hearted. Do not lose hope. The Lord is there. You are for truth. You are for charity. You are for justice. The Lord will take care of you. So many people tell me also, God will take care of us, Father. We are not able to do anything. God will take care. God sees, no? And finally, today's second reading ends like this. In your struggle against sin, you have not yet resisted to the point of shedding your blood. You have so far not shed your blood in your struggle against sin. Come on, struggle. Persevere. Continue till the end. It is not enough to begin well, end well. Let it be written in your tombs, this man was faithful to God. This is what the word of God invites us today. May the grace of this Eucharist strengthen us, motivate us to be always on the side of our Lord. Amen.